You know what happened? Maybe Americans should know this, because Trump tried to establish good contacts with Viktor Orban. You know what a big, from Orban's Hungary cultural figure, did 2 days ago? In a public statement, op-ed, he said that George Soros owns the biggest gas chamber in Europe, that he is worse than Hitler, that he's spreading a cyanide-like poison, which is called multicultural tolerance, and in this sense, he is today's Hitler. He says this, more dangerous than Hitler, more, and so on and so on. This is, and the, now people who accuse sometimes even you of anti-Semitism, I tell them, sorry, this is anti-Semitism. This is vulgar abuse, and I just wonder how often people who, you know, protect Israel when it's doing bad things, attacking the Palestinians, can be very anti-Semitic here. For example, you remember, Cornel, that guy, crazy guy, who a couple of years ago killed dozens in a social democratic camp, Breivik, the crazy Norwegian guy.
Oh, yeah.
Friends sent me his diaries, manuscripts, some of them translated. You know what's so interesting? There he defends Israel, the bastion protecting the West. But he says, but in the West, no Jews. They should move to Israel to protect us there. That is to say, it's this deep link between protecting Israel there, supporting Israel against the Palestinians, and remaining anti-Semitic here. And I claim Trump was also doing this in a more refined way. But so that, you know, would you agree, Cornel, when friends tell me, but you have to choose Palestinians or Israelis, I say, no, the moment you accept this as a choice, you sold your soul to the devil. This is the same struggle.
Yes, no,
must move you to protect Palestinians today. It's the same struggle.
Absolutely. No, I'm resonating deeply with you, my brother. But I love your notion of an ethical miracle.